Jacobus Ofor Jr. And I contested for the Old Tafo constituency parliamentary seat. And by the grace of God, I have emerged victorious. First and foremost, let me say a very big thank you to the Almighty God for this success. And secondly, a very big thank you to the delegates of Old Tafo Pankono for giving me this huge opportunity in a lifetime. I also want to say a very big thank you to my parents who have been supporting me spiritually. They've done a showman's job. They've proven that indeed they are good parents, and I'm grateful to them. One of the things that I know is that the people of Tafo Pankono will be expecting the kind of leadership that their aspirations will be heard in the bills in Parliament. And of course, that is the core mandate of Parliament, to be able to pass laws that will be used to govern this nation. And given the opportunity, what I'm going to do is to make sure that the aspirations will be heard in those bills. The people of Tafo Pankono is saying that they want a leader who will be available for them. They want one of their own. They want a soil. They want a soil of the sand. They want a son of the soil. And so we are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful for what the people of Old Tafo Pankono have been able to do for us. We hope that the few shoes that has been left by Dr. Antonio Kutose will be filled adequately, especially given some amount of time to be able to learn on the job. We hope that within the next few years, we should be able to be getting one Dr. Antonio Kutose again in Old Tafo Pankono. This is a party that rewards hard work if you contribute your quota to the party. And so, of course, within the next few hours, I should be able to extend some hands of togetherness to the people that who contested this race. They've given me a run for my money, and it's an indication that you cannot play or toy with the emotions of the delegates in Tafo Pankono, especially when it comes to the New Patriotic Party. Dr. Antonio Kutose has always been one of the perfect gentleman as far as Tafo Pankono is concerned, especially when you move to the Zongos. He's much loved in the Zongos. I am just hoping that we will be able to build on his successes, we will be able to build on his strength, so that we could be able to maximize the numbers. If it happens that we are able to do so, then we will give thanks to the Almighty God. We hope that we are able to do so, as I'm saying. Expect a servant leader, not one who is going to show that he's a leader just by doing things that one way or the other lord him or herself on the delegates. I think that I want to be available for my people, and because they've given me this huge mandate to be able to represent them in Parliament, and I cannot fail them, and I promise them that I'm going to give them very good representation in Parliament.
Sure.
That there were fashions as far as this contest is concerned. What I know is that there was a battle of ideas. Every delegate decided to join a particular candidate based on his or her beliefs, and that is what happened. And I know that I was able to have a chunk or a greater number of the people who are delegates to be able to buy into my ideas, and that is why I'm sitting here today as a victor as far as this election is concerned. So I don't see anybody to belong to any faction. What is important is that the Elephant Party is a big party. We need to work with everybody to be able to make sure that you deliver success to Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, who is the President of the Republic as we speak. Politics, when your contenders feels that you are strong, when they cannot beat you, they say things that are really not important. I was expecting that they would say that I don't have the ideas to represent the people of Tafo Pankono in Parliament. If that was the argument, then we could probably do that. But if the argument is not about whether I am intelligent enough to be able to represent the people of Otafu in Parliament, then I don't think it's an argument at all. It's worthless. It's not something that I want to engage myself in.
Okay, please.
What I can say is that there is no campaign after elections. When we are done with elections, we are done with elections. It now boils down to governance, and that is what I expect the people who supported each and every of the candidates to be able to do. I am going to personally take that up and extend some togetherness as far as the contenders are concerned to ensure that we will be able to deliver a very good success to the New Patriotic Party as far as Old Tafo constituency is concerned.
Thank you.